Whenever you're running a business, cash is king. When a business runs out of cash, it's out of business. And you, as the operator of that business, need to think about how much cash you need to hold on to. Biggest mistake I made in my first property that I owned was distributing too much cash back to the investors. Let me just tell you how naive I was. So we had family members that signed on to the deal as GPs. This is before you needed to have any type of balance sheet to show a bank. They signed on as GPs and they signed on the dotted line. It was a recourse loan. So they signed on to the deal as recourse borrowers. All the other investors signed on as non-recourse. So we were on the hook, and all the other investors below 25% were not on the hook. So because we were on the hook, our dollar invested purchased more of the membership interest than those people that were not on the hook that put up a dollar. Okay. So that was how we did it. One of those people who was involved in the deal as a GP was my brother-in-law. And to do this deal, to put the money in, he borrowed money off his home equity loan to buy into the deal. Remember, this is the frothy 2006-2007 era when nobody was going to lose any money. So he put up, you know, he took money out of his home in California and he invested in the deal. And every month he got a home equity line of credit bill. So he wanted a monthly distribution off the property. So I paid him a monthly distribution and I paid all the investors a monthly distribution. Should never have done that. Did it for all the wrong reasons. I was in charge. I should have hoarded cash. And then at the end of the year, made the decision as to how much cash I should distribute. But instead I said, well, my brother-in-law needs the money. So we sent out those monthly checks. And when we came up against a capital event, we didn't have enough money. We had to call in, you know, hey, you got to put more money into the deal. Never should have done that. Don't do that. That's why I say monthly distributions. Not only that, was a nightmare. I had to cut checks every single month to like 12 people. It became a pain in the neck. This is before we had these cottage industries of these systems like Invest to run the systems for you. We did it all ourselves. So don't get in that habit. Don't hoard your cash as the owner. Cash is king. Once you feel comfortable and you're safe, then you can distribute the capital. That's how you really need to think about running this type of business. That's my advice.